My dear P5 learners, welcome back to this online teaching. My name is Mr. Mugisha Emmanuel. In my previous lesson, I taught you about values of numbers, values of digits. And I also went ahead to teach you how we can apply values and place values given some questions. And I gave you an activity which I hope you did. So allow me just make a quick review of what we looked at. To have, for example, number one, which says, find the quotient of the value of 3 and 4 in the number 63,240. So I told you in this case, you are supposed to identify the keywords used in this question. One is quotient, okay? Another one is value of 3 and 4. So, do you know how to find the value of 3? Yes, I hope you know, you remember. Then the value of 4? Let's do that. How do we get value of 3 and 4? So we come and draw this table here. Then you say value of 3. Then value of 4. And the number is 63,240. Okay. How do we get a value? Remember I told you that value is equal to digits times the place value. So for this case, what is the digit? The digit is 3. What is its place value? We begin from our right. The first digit, 1s. The second one, 10s. The next one, 100s. The next one, 1000s. Then the last one here is going to be 10,000. So the digit is 3. The place value of 3 is 1000. So we multiply by 1000. And what do we get? We shall get our 3000. So the value of 3, the number is 3000. Then the value of 4. Still value is digit times the place value, of which the digit is 4. And the place value of 4 here is 10, so we multiply by 10, which is going to give you that one. But the question is demanding for the quotient. Do you remember the other four terminologies I gave you? I gave you sum, which means addition, gave you difference, which means subtraction, I gave you product, which means multiplication, and then quotient means dividing, or the number you get after dividing. So what is going to be our quotient? Our quotient is going to be 3000 divided by the 40. Okay? Then because of this one and this one, we can now reduce 300 by 4. We can even use 2. Divide by 2, we get 2. 3 divided by 2, we get 1. What is the remainder? 1 to make it 10. 10 divided by 2, 5. Then 0 divided by 2, we get that one. So we have 150. Which should be divided by these 2. Divide by 2, 1. 15 divided by 2, we are getting 7. What is the remainder? 1. Good. 10 divided by 2, which is 5. So it means our quotient there is 75. We have also another one. Calculate the product of the place value of 2 and the value of 5 in that number. So, identify the keywords here. We have product. You remember the meaning? Say the number you get after multiplying. Place value of 2, then value of 5. So, we draw our table. Whereby we need the place value of which digit? The place value of 2. Then we need the value of which digit? Of 5. So, what is the place value of 2 in the number? Remember the number is 5732. So, the place value, 1s, 10s, 100s, then 1000s. What is the place value of 2? The place value of 2 is 1s. What is the value of 5 in the same number? We say value is equal to digit times the place value. So the digit in this case is 5. And the place value is 1000. So
multiply by 1,000, which is going to give you 5,000. But the question is demanding for the product. So product, what do we do? We told you product means the number you get after multiplying. So it is 5,000 times the place value of 2, which is 1. Now am I going to multiply by a word? No. I told you that you change this word into a figure. So times 1. Any number times 1, you get that very number. So basically that's what we looked at in the previous lesson. Today, I am going to take you through another interesting lesson, which is expansion of numbers using place values. Expansion of numbers using place values. I just beg you to pay attention, understand this. Even if you go to the university, you will just find this one very easy for you to do. So, in our example one, we are expanding the following using place values. Using place values. So, our number which we are going to expand is 3,469. So, 469 is going to be expanded using place values. So it means you should first of all identify place values of each digit. What is the place value of 9? 1. What about 6? 10. What about 4? 100. What about 3? That is 1,000. Another key word is expand. So, how do we expand this number using place values? We are going to get the digit, which is 3. We multiply by its place value. So, its place value is 1,000. Plus 4 multiplied by its place value. And the place value of 4 is 100. Plus 6 multiplied by its place value. What is the place value of 6? 10. Plus 9 times its place value. What is its place value? 1, which is 1. We have been told to expand using place values. And this becomes my answer. Someone is saying, only that? Yes, only this. Let's have a look at another example. Part B. We are expanding this number. 7, 2, 6, 4, 9. Okay. How do we read this? 72,649. We are expanding this one using, again, place values. So I have told you that step 1, identify place values of each digit. So we have 7, 2, 6, 4, 9. So we begin from our right and I give the place values. What is the place value of 9? 1s. What is the place value of 4? 10s. What is the place value of 6? 100s. What is the place value of 2? 1,000s. And what is the place value of 7? It is going to be 10,000. Therefore, our answer is going to be digit 7 times its place value, which is 10,000. You put it in brackets, plus the next digit is 2 times its place value, which is 1,000, plus the next digit, which is 6, times its place value, which is 100s, then plus the next digit is 4, times its place value. What is the place value of 4? 10s. So times 10. Then lastly, we have 9 times its place value. What is the place value of 9? 1s. So we put here 1 and this one becomes our answer. As simple as that.
We are expanding using place values. And I have multiplied my digits using place values.
So, can I give you another example?
Example 3. We are expanding 4, 6, 7, 10, 8, 2, then 0. We are expanding that number. Which number is this? How do we read this? You know, a comma is making our number easy to read. So how do we read this one? The first three digits, 467, okay? Then the last three digits, 820. So this one becomes 467 in the place value of thousands, 820. So we shall have 467,820. Place value of each digit begins from your right. The first digit must be in the place value of 1 is represented by 0. The second one, place value of 10. Next one, hundreds. Followed by 1,000. Followed by 10,000. Then lastly, 100,000. Okay? The place value of 0 is 1, the place value of 2 is 10, the place value of 8 is 100, the place value of 7 is 1,000, the place value of 6 is 10,000, the place value of 4 is 100,000. So, my first digit is 4. Multiply it by. What is its place value? 100,000. You know how to write 100,000? Yes. We first write 100, then 1,000. We add here our three zeros. Put it in brackets. Plus. The next digit is 4. Multiply it by its place value, which is 10,000. So we first write 10, and 1,000 adds there three zeros. Plus. The next digit is 7, multiplied by its place value, which is 1,000. Then plus, the next digit is 8, multiplied by its place value, and the place value of 8 is 100. Plus, the next digit is 2, which is going to be multiplied by its place value, which is 10. So I put here 10. Plus, the last digit is 0, which is supposed to be multiplied by its place value, and its place value is 1. So I put here 1. Since I have been told to expand using place values, and these are the place values, so I don't need to take any other step. See how simple it is? I think you can now try some numbers. After all, this one is taught in P4, in P5, even in P6. When you go to P7, you shall repeat. You go to senior one, teachers repeat. You go to senior, they repeat until you complete the cycle of education. One more last example. You know, for me, I want to leave the floor when everybody has understood. I don't want to leave anybody who has not understood. So, the last example, D. We are going to expand. We are going to expand 9, 9, 9, 9, 9.
Oh, somebody said, oh my God, what is that?
Yes. How do we read this? Insert a comma, 1, 2, 3, comma. So, how do we read this? 99,999. So, we shall have 9, 9, 9, 9, 9. So, we are putting place values, exponent and 1s, followed by 10s, followed by 100s, followed by 1,000s, followed by 10,000. Okay? So, digit times place value, we are expanding using place values. The digit, 9, times the place value, 10,000. 10, then 3 zeros, 10,000. Plus, 9. Times its place value, 1,000. Relax. 9 times its place value, 100 times 100. Plus 9 times its place value, 10. So you multiply by 10. Plus 9 times its place value, 1. So we multiply by 1. I've been expanding using place values and I have multiplied using place values. So this one becomes my final answer. Oh, someone is saying, teacher, don't give us more examples, just give us an activity to show you. Thank you. I'm going to give you an activity of only 8 numbers. And those 8 numbers, I expect you to sit down quite so well in the Kampala Quality Classroom. And next time when I come, I'm going to go through the numbers so that we are able to award ourselves. Thank you so much for being good learners. Have a nice day.